Now, once you have installed this software, you have to just search local and you will be able to see that the installed app is available. You have to just click on this now. And this is the view which you will be able to see once you open the app. Here you can see I have already built 3 local websites. So you may not be able to see all these 3 because yours is just a fresh installation. So now what we will do is we will build a new website from scratch. So on the left hand side, you can see there is a plus button and it is showing add local site. So we will click on this plus button and it is prompting for a name. So it is asking what is your site's name. So we will put any name. Okay, I have put my first website 1. There is an advanced option available. So we don't have to do anything in this advanced options. We'll just keep it like this and we'll go to continue. So now you can choose your environment. Here you have 2 environments, preferred or custom. Preferred will do everything in default mode. So we will just set up in default mode and we will continue. Now it is asking for a username. So you can select any username, but you have to remember this because this will be your username and password when you start editing your site. So let me select one. Now here also we have some advanced options, whether it is a multi-site or not. We don't have to go to this option as well. And we'll keep the email as it is. There is no problem if this email is kept as it is. Then click on add site. So this process will take few minutes and it will also ask for some permissions. So it is asking for a permission. Do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? Now what this app is doing basically is, it is creating an environment for the website so that this PC works like a server. So we will click yes. So let it get installed and I'll be back once it is done.